always hear people talk about things like training, education, and development. Can you tell me what those are and how they relate to each other?
Okay. Yeah. Training essentially is about preparing the person for the workplace. You want
a specific workplace.
Right. You want to provide specific skills. So in a manufacturing setting, you may need to provide skills related to welding, machining operation. In an office, it may be skills related to accounting, telephone operating. So training is very specific, and you're looking at the workforce. Education is broadly based. Education would also include preparing persons for the work, for the workforce or the workplace. But education is broader base. Values would be included. And you are not provided with specific skills for any particular workplace, but generally you are given enough skills so that you can be employed at a workplace of your preference. Development, on the other hand, is about the individual. So you're in the organization, you're trained, but you have notions about increasing your skills or increasing your education. And this could be a course, a single course, or a degree program. So that is focused on the individual who wants to increase their competencies so that they can take on other job responsibilities, either there in the organization or in at another location. So development is really preparing you to make advances at the workplace.
All right, Doc, now a lot of companies in Jamaica are now setting up their own corporate universities. People like Sandals and so, I think NCB perhaps, but I know Sandals for sure. What is that all about? Because you would imagine, so what they're really doing is putting a fancier spin on on-the-job training. What exactly is happening
but
there?
One can make the assumption that they feel that they're better able to prepare the worker for the jobs that they have.
Mm-hmm.
One would also see them doing a greater level of on-the-job activities, on-the-job training. The persons who are selected, they would be specially selected based on their qualification. Do they need persons with 5 CXC? And CXC in what area. And so I would want to suggest that in terms of preparing the person, when the training is done by the organization, you have a better chance of matching the training with the required skill.
Okay. All right, so the truth is universities like ours cannot do everything.
Precisely, because you're not going to be so focused.
Yeah, we are in the realm of development.
Precisely.
More development.
Right, and we want to be a person, not for just one type of organization, those persons in service organization or hospitality,
mm-hmm.
that's required for the hotel. But the university is providing persons and general skills for persons across the board.
Because I've been doing some reading in training, and one of the things I'm seeing is that you have a lot of proactive and reactive aspects to the program.
Mm-hmm.
So I imagine that universities will be seen as more proactive.
Mm-hmm.
We are trying to project into the future
what
needs will be.
Right. So as proactive is you anticipate what will happen 2 years from now, 5 years from now, and start to prepare your workforce. What you don't want is a situation where you're ready to pursue a new line of activity at the workplace, and lo and behold, you do not have the workers in place. There's a best example of this, one could point to Jamalco a number of years, I think it was 2008. They decided before the financial crisis to expand the activities and the plant at Jamalco, What they found out just before they started is that they had no welders.
Oh, wow.
No welders. So what they decided to do was to work with Hartrust NTA to train welders, and they were doing well until the crisis came and that went to naught. But at least a number of persons were trained well, and they would have got jobs either here in Jamaica or abroad.
All right, you mentioned Hartrust, and that actually would have been my next question. Mm-hmm. These national training agencies, mm-hmm. what is their role in all of this?
Well, Hartrust NTA, National Training Agency, represents the training entity for Jamaica. And what is unique about that is the entity is funded at 3% by the employers. And that is funded, well, that started from the 1980s and continues. So the aim, it started because persons leaving the school system really had no skills at all. They have a basic education, they may pass then GCE subjects or JSE, the local examination, and that was it. When you go to the workplace, you would have to be trained starting from scratch. So Hartrust decided to intervene. The government decided to create the trust, Hartrust NTA, and they, from the 1980s to now, have been providing training right across the board, maybe in over 19 different areas.
Yes.
The hotel industry benefited significantly.
Yes.
You go to one of the Jamaican hotels, and most likely, some of those guys who worked there would have been trained by Hartrust NTA.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And am I right in thinking that there are NTAs in other islands in the Caribbean?
Right. Trinidad and Tobago would have, and also Barbados. But in terms of funding, I think that 3% of the wage bill, I think we were lucky then to have the agreement. Any country now won't be so lucky to get persons to agree to any such thing. But I think even as we speak, and some employers may be concerned, I think it's going to be around for some time, because Hartrust is always taking steps to make sure that companies will benefit from the training that they offer.
So what that means is that they send their students out for internships?
For internship, and at times they collaborate with companies to deliver training, like the one with Jamalco.
Yes.
This was an example of Jamalco collaborating with Hartrust NTA. And right now they are looking at working in addition to training school leavers, which was the essence of that program. They are targeting organization and intervening by training their workforce.
Okay. All right. Thanks a lot, Doc. Thanks. Mm-hmm.